Alright, this is a much better hand than last time. Opponent's still on the play. I mean, Blister Grub plus Trigon of Rage, that's a beating. So, then I've got a curve. And Phyrexian Ranger, that's a good one too. So, let's lead with the Plains, obviously. So that if I draw a Sky Hunter, I can get it going. Alright, Ichor Claw Mirror, alright. Let's get Trigon of Rage going. I think I can race Ichor Claw Mirror with a Blister Grub. That becomes a 5-5. Something else is gonna... Well, becomes a 3-3. I guess Reaver trades with Ichor Claw Mirror as well. So, Blister Grub? If I go with Blister Grub, then I could play Glinthook Idol and Pump. So I guess that's what I would like to go with. I mean, Blister Grub's gonna be such a game. I mean, Blister Grubs will kill in 4 turns versus the Ichor Claw Mirror, which doesn't scare me so much. Alright, Horizon Spell Bomb goes for a land. Not sure how much value you're really gonna get out of that extra land. Effect decks generally not needing the mana so much. Ichor Claw is in for another one, which is fine. Alright, Trigon of Corruption, certainly a good one. I don't think it changes my plays though, because I'm still going to get value out of Blister Grub, even if it does die in 2 turns. So, that in mind. In for 5, baby. Yeah. Alright, so next turn, I'm going to want to activate Idol and Trigon, and then does that leave me with any mana? Not so much. Okay. So if I activate Trigon, that's 2, and then I can either activate Idol. Yeah, I think I might be happier not activating Idol. And then play a Reaver instead, or a Rager. By the way, I'm going to attack in, let's fire, 4, puts into 11. I think we're going to leave the Glinthook Idol back, perhaps. That doesn't give my opponent the option to put Trigon of Corruption counters on Blister Grub. So, on the Glinthook Idol. Because, I mean, as it stands, okay. So, I definitely didn't want Glinthook Idol to be dying to the double up shenanigans then. Okay. So, now, between Reaver and Rager, if Rager gets me a card, they can both chump block, Rager gets me a card, Reaver attacks for 3, is that relevant? I think it might be relevant. My opponent's only at 13. If my opponent doesn't have a blocker, then Reaver can just get in for 5 if it gets a Trigon of Corruption counter, which keeps me on track. And then I'll still have the mana up to get more action on the table. Okay, so I think... Do I want to activate Glinthook Idol? Yeah. Activate Glinthook Idol, and then I pay 2 for Trigon, and then that leaves me enough mana for a Phyrexian Rager? That seems fine. Alright, we're going to attack. Bam. Certainly putting up the numbers here. Alrighty, the Reaver. I will pump. Assume you're putting a -1/-1 counter on. Oh, okay, pistol strike, okay. I still get in for damage, right? Yeah, okay. So still getting in for 5. And following up with Rager. Alrighty, Perilous Mirror, quite a good one to be drawing. So, I should still be able to keep up in this race, even after I take another one, putting me to 7 poison, and of course all these Pistol Strike and Virulent Wound adding to the poison counters. I think I can still afford to take another poison damage. Certainly if I go Mearsmith, Perilous Mirror, that kind of play. Okay, okay. So... ooh, or Victory's Herald, that would work too. But I think I want that counter to come off first so that I can just run out Mearsmith. Mearsmith and Perilous Mirror. I think I'd rather have Mearsmith and Perilous Mirror and a Mirror Token on the table. So that litters up the table before playing the Victory's Herald. It just puts me in a more solid position. Okay, or he could just not activate the Trigon. I guess that's play two. In which case, okay, I will play Victory's Herald. How do you like that? So, I'll have my opponent nearly dead next turn, if there's no answer to the Herald. Oh, Grasp of Darkness? No, okay. Just putting a -1/-1 counter on. I bet my opponent's kicking himself for pitching the Pistol Strike a little too early. Although, I mean, I was putting serious pressure on. So it's not like my opponent had the luxury to hold onto it either. So, gonna be in a pretty good position when I bash in for 5 and leave Perilous Mirror back. That is for sure. I mean, well, it's going to be Mearsmith, Perilous Mirror, and a Mirror Token. Black Cleave Goblin, huh? Okay. So, I do have to chump something. I guess chumping a Black Cleave Goblin, I guess that's going to be fine. Alright, so... I mean, I guess I still attack for 3 because I'm going to leave 3 creatures back. Which should be more than sufficient. So, in for 3 here. And lifelink, yeah. So, Mearsmith, and then... I guess Blade and Sentinel is going to be better than Perilous Mirror here. Seeing as how I've got the option for both of them. I mean, Perilous Mirror will kill Ikkoclaw Mirror, but I don't think that's really going to come into play. All I need to do is chump Ikkoclaw and then bash for the win. Yeah. I mean, extra toughness, can't think of any board sweepers that would really, you know, make a difference so much. But, I don't know, if the board was going to be swept right now, I'd rather have Perilous Mirror back than Bladed Sentinel, to be honest. Perilous Mirror, at the very least, is going to get in for another 2 damage. Guaranteed. So, opponent's going to attack with Ikkoclaw. Yes, I guess double block is fine here. I don't see any reason not to kill it. I really don't have to, but I don't see any reason not to. Okay, whoa. Right. So, anyway, well, I mean, if my opponent had, spread the sickness, kill the Rager, proliferate to kill the Herald, and go to one, well, actually, that wouldn't work, because Seize Initiative would kill him, but, you know, I don't think there's any outs in green and black now. We're just gonna get in with the crew. Pretty sure this one is done. Alright, Miss Smith. Can die? Sure. You gonna kill the Herald as well? Or what's going on? Nope, that's all. So, that was a pretty good haul. Win in the 4-3-2-2 and pulling a sweet sort of body in mind. So, yeah, that worked out pretty nicely. Thanks for watching.